inside the apartment with our anti-hero detective and his rather duty-bound ravishal Precinct 57 partner. Three different sizes. Yeah. Probably about 4 hours into this game. And yes, I've taken my time to really try to take it in, and there's a lot to take in here. First of all, just the setting, right? It looks like your traditional kind of painted 3D game, except in this case is demonstrated by the flashlight and the shadows we're seeing here. This is actually 3D geometry with a kind of, you might call it, painterly effect of visuals here. I think that's quite an interesting choice. Of course, the characters are kind of painterly in terms of the textures, but they're clearly 3D models. So this is actually a bona fide 3D world with a fixed camera that you can kind of just really zoom in and out, and that's it. But the 3D-ness and geometry of the world becomes more apparent when there are especially lighting interactions with it. Of course, there are things like the fan. Second thing is the characters in this place. So this is a fictional world in a timeline close to our world.
Yes.
And he's not going to tell me anything useful. Nothing for now. They have cassette tapes, so I guess there's that. Now let's go in here. Slimy bathroom here. Let's see what we can see here. That seems like a great place to take alcohol. Ooh, I think I'm supposed to drink some alcohol. It's one of my quests, because back on the subject of the anti-hero detective. So yeah, clearly an anti-hero because wake up drunk, passed out, unable to remember even why you're even there. While you seem to display some traits of being a capable, logical, reasoning detective, you seem also just really bad at your job. Lack of diligence. You've been here for a week and you still haven't made any headway on this murder. The body is still hanging on a tree. And in a way, you don't really have a high opinion of yourself or really of anyone. And of course, the game has you talking with your kind of inner psyche, with different parts of yourself. A pair of chain cutters would make short work of it. Well, let's put the tool in hand, I guess. Let's try that again. Ooh. Well, probable cause, I guess. I guess my by the books, more or less, partner here seems to at least not disapprove. So let's go in. Krasmazov was an economist and theoretical historian. He was a leading figure on the Grad side of the turn of the century revolution, where he headed the 9-day government. Mazov is considered the father of scientific communism, Mazovian thought, or Mazovianism. Krasmazov, K.M., Karl Marx. I don't know. Why does this tenant have a bust of Krasmazov in their bedroom? White shard photos on the wall, I think, broken into the apartment of a young communard. Drowned before. How fitting. Russians love to pose with their guns. Sometimes that seems to be true. Books of critical theory and monstrosity's capital and such. Okay, anything else in this room? Why don't we steal their belongings? Why not? Already broken into their place. Maybe the least we can do is close the door. Partly to hide our crime here, having broken in. So yes, the anti-hero. Your kind of protagonist without the, you know, shall we say, more traditional traits of being a hero. You know, courage, valor, sense of justice, and all of that. An anti-hero, by contrast, as we seem to be here in this game, has a rather more mixed set of all of those. Locked door, I hear someone walking around the side range. Furniture number 10. Yeah. Thank you, Kim, for being a voice of reason. It's generally easier to do things if you have literally any reason. That is quite an astute, logical reasoning there. Postcard. Take more money.
The coal never does any good for my bronchitis. I'm fine. Don't you worry about me. Now, what you want from me, policeman?
If you call it living, she spits on the floor before wiping it off with a broom. A little room upstairs, right next to the coal room. It's barely bigger than a closet, but I don't complain, no. She juts out her chin, eyes shining. I have my bed and my aching bones to keep me company, and that's all I need from this world. Ooh, grim indeed. She hasn't spoken to anyone for a while, and her sentences feel rusty. Interesting. I love this kind of, rhetorical perception that I seem to have. Of course, I did choose to be a thinker in this game, this particular playthrough of the game, so you know, kind of, I guess I could be more attuned to the rhetorics of those who I encounter. Yes, I know who you mean. Scrawny boy who's always smoking like the devil, right? She looks at the other end of the hallway and says, somewhere in the building, a child starts crying. You hear a radio tuned to a talk show and someone taking a shower. What's he in trouble for? Talk. Yeah, what was so funny? 28. Go to the balcony. It's one of those doors there. Usually home. Thank you. Seek his home. That one's a scientist, a future scholar. Suddenly the old lady's face is beaming. He studies astrology, the community college, education's good, and I always tell them to study astrology. Something to do with all those stars around his door. He asked me to leave his drawings up on the wall. And star and antlers. See where we can go. A flash of ideas and atrocities are far from her world. Fairies are far from her world. Fairies and wizards. All I know about politics is that it has brought us more harm than good. Yeah, she may be onto something there. Balcony. Go up there. What's going on here? Sea floor looks cold and winter gray. One side. That is. Ruination has come. The broken arches betrayed the once grand history of this building. It towered over this harbor until it happened. The great force from the northeast fired at the city. Heavy artillery shelled the coastlines, fired from the water. A straight shot into Ravishal. Tenement acted as a defensive wall against the worst of the shelling until it was destroyed and they had a direct firing line. The waves, the Martinez Inlet, and roll over the fallen remains of the building. The dark waters obscure the better part of the remains. What didn't fall into the ocean was used as scrap. What wasn't used as scrap was thrown into the ocean. Those arches acted as support for something greater than what you see now. Only 3 stories stand where 9 to 12 once did. Restoration has failed. What the shelling took out was never rebuilt. Who did this damage? A fleet. The combined armies of the Occident and Grodd with Mesk volunteers. A 5-nation army. Hundreds of vessels. Master airships. Further down the bay of Ravishal, the artillery was so powerful the ships not only required gyroscopic stabilization, they were anchored into the ocean floor as well. Many are still there to this day. If you squint, you can just barely see the shadow on the water far in the northeast. Cannons still ready to placate a Ravishal. Ship Archer can shoot 50 shells a minute on 20 coal-lined arches. They will reach the city in 58 seconds. Coalition, says the lieutenant. They shelled our city, but that was a long time ago. I think we should move on. It's chilly up here.
The streets will flow red once more. A great torrent rushing down Rue d'Espérance. You wait and see.
The streets will not flow red with anything. Who are you?
I'm Cindy the fucking Skull. What else do you want to know? Date of birth? Blood type? The last time I was tested for Hep C? And here I was, trying to be polite. Just can't win with you pigs.
Ozone. Its money and residence used to posh restaurants and upscale boutiques barely have reason to visit. Martinez is she. You should talk to her. I have a feeling she's a professional negotiator, though. I have a feeling she'll be very cooperative while telling us nothing. Do my anti-hero thing. Ask her unexpected questions. That's good to know. are severely lacking in havoc. Not even the occasional trash can fire to break up the tedium. I do love public art, especially one with, a reason, any reason, as we said. Behind it, though, hopefully they're thoughtful. Thanks, I'm sure the inspiration will come to me now that I have an official RCM stamp of approval. That may be sarcasm. Oh, yeah. Do you know anything about the recent, I like that. Thank you. time to apply my anti-hero unconventional charms.
Good afternoon, officers. I'm Joyce. Joyce L. Messier. I represent the Board of Wild Pines, the owners of the harbor. You gentlemen must be from the RCM. Layton, my maiden name. I'm glad to see you here. I was dispatched to handle a strike, not a lynching. Anything I can do to assist the RCM in this matter, I will, gladly.
That is good to hear, madame. My colleague will take the lead on this interview. I should let you know that he is recovering from an unusual medical episode. Very unusual. But I can assure you of his ultimate competency.
Thank you, Kim.
How interesting. I wish you a swift recovery. In the meanwhile, you have my full cooperation and the full cooperation of the Wild Pines group.
You're on a boat. Need to make this lady admit she's only riding around on this boat because she's rich. Yes, I do. I'm sorry. Let's do it. senior labor negotiator. In practice, I'm a grocery clerk. I relay the union's demands to Wild Pines and return with Wild Pines a counteroffer. Jean-Luc Measurehead. Calmont hit a wall with Mr. Claire, the union boss. Heavens no, this is not the first time the union's gone on strike. There have been two prior strikes. Both times the union wants significant concessions, include an overtime pay and a medical plan. This time the demands are more, I guess you could say, aggressive. We detect that she really seems to suggest, imply, ludicrous, even. What happened to this one? Not sure, naturally I assumed that it was just their opening position, a hard-nosed tactic with a side of a mockery. There's been no follow-up, just the same nonsensical smoke repeat over and over again. Now, people are getting lynched, I hear, behind the whirling in rags, a disastrous situation if there ever was one. Excuse me, Lieutenant, from whom did you hear about this lynching? First heard from the Boa advocates, the one whose very name advertises aversion to work, and he said it was Call Me Mañana. We met that person. In your opinion, Detective, if I may ask, I'm a curious and talkative person, you see. Would you say the Union is... What? What could happen? The rats of locomotive, giant leech. Mission to share with you includes sensitive trade secrets. For the sake of my employer, I have to ask for your names and badge numbers. Of course, ma'am, we should introduce ourselves. And he doesn't have his badge a moment. Now, curious. Why is that, detective? Stolen by some artists. Surely best to pin the blame on them. Everyone knows you can't trust artists. Ha. Why should I blame an artist? Some artist stole my badge or staked. Everyone knows you can't trust artists. Well, as a computer music researcher, I have no comments on that one. As I said, ma'am, his technique may be very unconventional, but he is an officer of the RCM. Not gonna work. Nope. Ouch. Lonesome long way home. Here we go. Thought complete. Home awaits. Walk past Station 41 and through the market, past the Boogie Street spearhead to the other side of the lake. Frozen Eye at the center of the district, then past the video rental store in the corner. There at the end of the street lined pine trees, a small house, no larger than a matchbox. 11 Voyager Road. You no longer live there. Those times are gone, and so are those people. Why did you come here? Why are you still here? Why? Where's the dealer? You have to go back to work. Sorry. Wait, I think. So. The world is large, and your badge is 8 by 6 centimeters.
You're back. Good. What can I help you with?
Sounds from Terminal B to smuggle raw ingredients from the Simmering Solo into the Red Shoal with Union's blessing. Wild Pines is expected for years. Ingredients for what, man? Meth and dextroamphetamine. GB on rare synthetic psychedelics. Honestly, it would be quicker to say what you can't make from this stuff. I met such a person. We did ask about what are you carrying. Irises are light green like the river Esperance in bright daylight, upstream where it's clearer. Thank you. A well-kempt yet tastefully short bob of dark hair. Despite the first glints of gray, she's elected to keep it all natural. Shaped into a permanent weave, late 40s style. While dull orange pearls hang from her earlobes, her red from cold, her light green eyes scan you full of knowledge and worry, wealth and all its possibilities. Inland Empire. Forget what that is. What is this? What am I talking to? This is part of my brain. Wow, actually mustered the the courage or whatever to actually ask for money. Of course, this will kind of really mess up the investigation, but you know what? I am an anti-hero detective, so you seem rich. Yes, I'm rich. How much money do you need? Hopefully not too much. Well, it pays off from that. It's a good sum. Dang. I got money to pay back my my tab. The whirling in rags. Again, this is probably like, you know, shouldn't take on a case and also get money from the person that informed you. Yep. You're right, ma'am, that donations are permitted under the Emergency Act, as seemingly as it may be, as long as they're properly logged with the precinct. Which he most certainly will do, she bows, and faces in high brown direction. Now, how else can I help the RCM today? Besides supplementing its salaries. Well, I think it's time. Seems like a kind of a not a graceful gesture, but then again, this is, she is such a good negotiator that she makes me feel this way. What do I do? What do I do? All right, let's go for it. It's not going great. Not giving up. Oh my, she inspects the motion. It's as if there's a tiny spinner on the side of his head. He's reeling thoughts out. except he isn't. I don't understand what is happening here. First, let's get some morale back. Swear to God, I'm really sharp. I don't know what's happening. Why am I not killing it? Okay, let's, oh boy. Well, you win some and you, you know, lose a lot, but you win some. I got some money. The humiliation at the end only further exacerbated the whole exchange, but more morale, I'll take it. It's good that, you know, morale drugs just lying around. Oh, hey, is this the bookstore? This is. Oh, I can still go over here. Just gonna go talk to that dude who was smoking. Yep, we're back here again. How do I get up there? That is the question. So now we've gone in a circle, but we've learned so much. Let's see, someone didn't look in here yet. What's this? Flip up glasses and the auditor. Something here already. Stars and the antlers just means that's all. Breaking it in. Oh my God, I got a compliment from Kim. Some kind of a moribund old man who used to be a business owner. Yeah, I didn't mean to insult the apartments lady. As Kratos and those radio computer wizards. Yeah, I like my current green shoes. It matches my jacket. Nope.
Give me a moment.
Indeed. You know what I can say to you?
Give me a moment.
Nope. Okay, so somehow make it up to the balcony up there. Kim doesn't even bother coming up. Let's look at the ocean one more time. Do that. Well, at least I did some things. So it's almost 8 o'clock. Get to it.
Hello again, my man. What's on your mind?
Good opening. Talk to the racist guy.
Looking for something, Hunt? Huh? Coming to tell me to fuck off again?
Yeah, I'm gonna ask you about whether you're smuggling ingredients for drugs. Look at the statue.
Hola, wandering man.
Hello again, officer. How are things?
Don't be shy. These are premium class clothes. Good quality fabrics, best retro design. Save the economy with your style, officer. I can see you have a taste for luxury, officer. Can't keep your eyes off those sneakers? You like sunglasses, officer? I've got the latest styles right here. Thank you.
are those as hats? Yeah, can't believe these have no, like, negative attributes. My shoes give me right now. Yeah, super stylish now. Super stylish now. Oh yeah. Water lock out of order until Wednesday, 7:15 a.m. Okay. Glad Kim had some as well. Day is it? Level up.
Not often that I see officers of the RC. What can I do for you? Oh no, not at all. I guess I haven't had many customers lately. RCM or otherwise.
Who are your customers usually?
all kinds of people come through here. Locals, travelers, people looking for a deal, people looking for a keepsake, people who are terminally bored. As you can see, I have a wide selection of goods for everyone to choose from. It keeps me entertained.
It's like a meltdown. No one's, everyone's. And hope themselves a primitive nuclear reactor, hoping for the best. What do you think is going to happen? What? I was here? Oh my goodness, I pawned my gun. And some woman came in and bought my gun that I pawned to the pawn shop. This is all about having, like, crowdsourced everything, like the citizens militia, this kind of, like, homebrew, you know, nuclear pile. the charts of photon emissions. This is really interesting. Like, part of this is like people speak with a vague French accent. We seem to be in kind of, I don't know, Eastern Europe at the same time, and also on an archipelago. And then there are, you know, like magnetic cassette tapes and guns with photon emissions. Is this guy serious? Bar didn't seem like a policeman, although she kept referring to herself as a pig, which was odd. I found her interest in the gun a bit obsessive, but I was just happy to get rid of it. Oh, she was terrifying. Oh boy. So, let me get this right. Lieutenant turns to you. You sold your sidearm, issued by the citizens' militia, and now civilians run around the streets of Martinez with it. I'm sorry, I sold my gun. Keeping this stuff. Ricker's self-critique gained as a thought. All right, I'm gonna have to think on that. Of course you are. It's okay. So you can get something out of this, like info. Maybe every time you say you're sorry, you get $1 million. That won't happen logically. Nope. Oh yeah. Temporary research bonus, 1 authority. Embarrassment to the party, research, timer 6 hours. You're one sorry piece of shit. A cop penitent, a flagrant cop monk. This is not the right line of work for you. You should be groveling at the feet of a feudal lord, providing lurid evidence against yourself at a Mazovian show trial, or ripping the flesh from your back with a cat of nine tails. Whatever made you this way, you can be damn sure it was your own damn fault. Do it. Really criticize yourself. Who knows? You might uncover something of importance from your guilt-ridden past. Yeah, I'm gonna have to think on that. Maybe they have the karaoke. Sounds pretty cool. I'm thinking this. Music. Really stylish. Permanent or is it not? I even have a living room. Photon emissions. So maybe my gun isn't a photon emitting gun. What's the deal with the man on his t-shirt? I do need help remembering basic facts about reality. Both Matt and Hildodale are an ontological necessity. Hey, it's not worth getting into talking about that. Interesting. Stuff in this pawn shop. I can find a plastic bag, that'd be nice too. So I'm gonna talk to the drivers, pay off my debt, inspect the bodies. There's a lot to do. Back to the whirling and rags. I am in a stylish visor, stylish yellow gloves that apparently increase my ability to interface with the world, I think. Met interesting people. There were three drivers, lorry drivers. I only talked to two. Who's the third one? Back to this convenience store. This is the third lorry driver that Joyce is talking about. This person still passed out here. Since I'm a detective, I probably should, I'm trying to solve a crime, let's go ahead and commit another one. and I'm robbing this person at the same time. Wow, it feels so dirty. Let's get out of here. It's like the worst detective ever.
Hello again, sweetie. I see you met up with your colleague. You are a handsome man, officer, with your moustache and your chiseled jaw and that silly dimple on your chin. But, dear, you're not for me. I'm too old and too married besides. You must forgive me. I'm getting so scatterbrained, I completely forgot to introduce myself. I'm Lena. My husband Morel and I are staying with our friend Gary just down the street, but I come here for tea when they're away.
Drank so hard, forgot literally everything. Zone of control led by an alliance of foreign powers called the Coalition with almost no government of our own, and certainly no dictatorship of the proletariat. That was where the citizens' militia. A reality lockdown. Yeah, this Everard will learn may not be the most scrupulous individual.
Can I help you?
How do I pay you?
So in the question, kind of sad thing, it's supposed to shit.
Oh wait. Oh no, I spent too much money, I can't pay him back anymore. I don't have a place to live.
Oh, I'm so close to paying this person back. Even closer. Lynn Empire. Hunches and gut feelings. Pretty low in empathy. Definitely no authority. Esprit de corps. We connect to station if we understand culture. Charm and run play the puppet master. My conceptualization. I'm doing it. And then I'll be able to go back in because I can pay my rent. Hey, it's almost time to debrief.
We should think about calling it a day, maybe. The nights are still miserably cold this time of year.
Dude, almost out of money. Motor carriage. Yeah. It's quite interesting. So, before I even figure out anything on my on this, trying to solve this crime, I gotta solve sleeping first. Okay, dude, what do you got? Dang, Kim. $200. Dang. Clutch. Run to the pawn shop.
Hello, hello. Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Thanks, Kim. What a partner. It's getting late. Let's jog back to the Whirling in Rags.
Can I help you?
Go figure out what we learned.
Yes. Yes.
Can call me Jay. Save.
Just a moment. You had some questions earlier, I believe. And besides, we should discuss our progress on the investigation. Let's go out to the balcony.
All right. We were just there. I wanted to talk to you. And given my weird behavior, how can I fault anyone else, even a video game, for behaving rather strange?
Where shall we begin? We should talk about the investigation, first and foremost. But I also remember you wanting to discuss the RCM.
Yeah. You were so hungover that you couldn't keep it down when we were first hanging, man. So we didn't even inspect the body. Yeah, you say. Not a lot of progress on the body inspection front. There's still much to do with the crime scene, too. We even searched it thoroughly. Yeah. Yeah, thanks. I try to walk. I love walking, especially in beautiful video games. But what does that project to in my responses here? Definitely that one. Doris Day. Historic figure. Author of the modern age. I'll have to look elsewhere for opinions. The subject of humanism is too abstract for me. I'll try now to have opinions on facts until they change. And accept the dirty city below. Doesn't look like that's about to happen. And what's called the Twilight of International Law. The laws we claim to enforce come from the MI. Without them, we're simply vigilantes. Yeah, well. It's hard to say. The dying lights of the city shimmer with glow. Slowly, like luminous clouds, they pass on his lenses. The lieutenant looks at his slim cigarette, contemplating the next traffic. Narrow static passes overhead, the whiskers with floodlights on the ground below. Kitsuragi's glasses light up as he looks up to the sky, two glowing circles. I really don't like us here. Uni and the teenagers too. It's different inland. Jamrock and the GRIH. Why are they like this? It's our fault for leaving this place to the dogs, to the union, to the company. Not daring to come here more often. This place has fallen between the cracks. The jurisdictions are two precincts. We run the city. West River is RCM land. It's incredibly hard. Human beings are... But we are in control, and it's worth it. The organization works, our systems work. If they didn't, the city would disintegrate. We have to be an optimist, me too. We wouldn't count any drastic changes in our lifetimes. He's very tired. The dark circles under his eyes make him look younger, not older. I'll say again, this is really good writing. My rhetoric. Day one, I feel like I did a lot, but accomplished very little. Alright, Kim. I guess it's my bed. That is. And also because I cannot remember. Me. It's interesting. So this is all very internal, right? So the, as far as the game's concerned, all of these things, well, they're all kind of from your internal point of view. And so before you could remember or actually see yourself in the mirror, you kind of were just a blob, which I was for this entire first day. And when I wipe the mirror, or dare to wipe the mirror, I now have a clear conceptualization of what I look like. What is that expression? Belongs to the new, the third decade of the current century. Times passed from the failure of the revolution, therefore a fleeting moment free market economy seemed like the ultimate uncontested way of life for our species. Well, that has no connections to our current reality whatsoever. Being sarcastic, of course. Things were good. It was smooth sailing. People made gold. Champagne-tinted interiors and facades to suit the times, calling this the new style, but more importantly, disco habit. What there is disco. Some of these things are more good than bad. And let's recall the name of this game, Disco Elysium. I mean, in a way, this is kind of a social, cultural, political, economic commentary on this post-war, post-revolution times in Revachol, but perhaps, I don't know, of our own world somehow? Forget about ostentatious orchestrations for Revachol, your city. It's only one thing. I don't think I can pronounce that. Just run. Used to spur on a horse. It also features in that person's regional mega hit. Don't worry. Like, police officer, what do you say? I'm armed and dangerous. How long ago is the new? There's a vast ocean of time between right now and the expression looking good on you, or anymore, or anyone. 2 decades, if the calendar is to be trusted. Humanity has run aground in that time. It is a different world now. The expression is a relic. Anything else? Like, who am I? Why did I become a cop? What did I drink myself into oblivion? You have some understanding of the near history of disco. Plus the trivia you've picked up along the way. Episodic memory, however, remains in the dark and may never return. You should prepare yourself for that. Not really. Oh, must have just stirred your mind. They're more like a disco rock band anyway. Not gonna work.
Thank you.
Time for sleep. The sheets feel at once coarse and clammy against your skin, the bad sags beneath your weight as you stretch out and finally close your eyes. I love this nuance of detail. It's all like, it's mainly text driven and graphics and some interaction, but it's all of this is supporting this really like intensely internal experience that extends in the muscles relaxed. Let's try the other side. Colors, scenes, and half-formed phrases still litter your mind. Part of you is still trying to solve the case, isn't it? Something to do with, what was it? Lieutenant said, Union? And it's gone again. Your thoughts lost between the slowing brain waves. Looking steadies, good silence washes over you until your eyelids twitch in your sleep and images start forming. Disco lights and the disco ball.
Do you remember the scent of your childhood? What it says on the can, Harry? Answer the question.
Harry?
Do you remember your wife's hand on your face? You know who I am. I'm the bad day. The one where you ask her, and then later in the streets, wandering. It's the worst day of all time, Harry, dear. And it's coming. She will hear about it on the phone. Reality will turn into a grotesque nightmare. This will be the last thing you did to her. Tell me. Do you remember the love of your life? Do you remember the warmth of her thighs, between her legs and in her mouth? Oh no, funky baby, you stayed. It was the rest of it that left. While you just stood there, with one hand on the bottle, and the other on your dick, watching it go. Tell me, where are your friends? Human beings have friends, Harry boy. Where the hell are yours? No, it's gone. 3 times gone. And never coming back. You failed. You failed me. You failed Elysium. Everything. The pile and the isolas on the surface. The outer magnetosphere. Burning, furious truth. 8,000 years of written history. You really dropped the ball, Harry. 4.6 billion people, and you failed every single one of them. You really fucked up.
8,000 years of written history. Is this in the future? 4.6 billion people.
No, you haven't. You're just sleep talking. And the act is wearing thin, too. The spots on the disco ball fade around you. You'll be back in those cold snakeskins in no time. Sweating up the bed.
Stinky boy.
You're not coming back from shit. Thrashing around in that high conductivity state of yours, bumping into things and acting like a clown? Who are you kidding? You're trying to what? I can't hear you. This is just a word dream now. Jumbled up garbage. The pictures are gone. The bed rises to meet you. A thin, sleep-like state. More glass than velvet, grinding in your head.
Something is wrong. Sleep shouldn't be this bad. This dry, this unnourishing. There's something wrong with your thoughts. Some kind of new type of hangover. Oh yes, party boy. And it's worse than the one before. Just think of the shit you saw. Here it comes, too. So soon already, a silent alarm goes off in your head like clockwork. Barely let you sleep at all. Time to get those clothes on, Harry. Time to go to work in the shit factory.
And we are in the morning, day two. Oh, just a dream. You have ones like that all the time. You feel even worse this morning than you did last night. Great. Like I said, anti-hero. You and Speed will be happy again. You will make her come home. This time it will be different. Okay, save the game again. Really lovely game, just full of surprises is just the very definition of what a game is, like what the rules of engagements are in a video game. And this one just really departs from, but still it makes use of game mechanics to kind of get really inside like your own head, literally kind of, because you're talking to like your own logic, you're talking to your rhetoric, you're talking to your different senses.
inner outer dialogue, and meanwhile you're an amnesiac drunk detective solving a murder, but really solving somewhere between jack shit and like everything, like philosophically everything, capital E. It's quite a game. Looking forward to more of it.